one of my favorites, and I'm so happy to have her tonight. So put your hands together for the very funny Jen Living Good.
Woo! Woo! Well, thank you. So, I'm living in Illinois. I lived in Boston for about 10 years, and, I got used to the culture there for 10 years. I mean, that's a good amount of time, and I did notice some differences between Midwesterners and Bostonians. Like, for example, when people are trying to say no. So a Midwesterner is going to say no like this. Well, I'm not really sure about that. I'd have to say, Whereas Bostonian's a little bit more direct. They're going to say, fuck no. I can't even really say that right. So I guess I really didn't learn much in those 10 years that I was there. So moving back to the Midwest, I've had to make an adjustment of driving. Half the time I'm in the car and I'm screaming, move, damn it. So I'm at a stoplight and I notice that people just kind of look around at things and light turns green, still looking around at like squirrels and cows and shit. And I'm like, come on, let's go. Why don't you look at a cell phone like everybody else does when they're driving? And so, yeah, I use the device called the horn. And I noticed that Midwesterners, they perceive that a little bit differently than Bostonians. I mean, if you honk at somebody in Boston, they're likely to give you the finger. They're likely to shout something at you or just plain don't even care if you honk at them. If you honk at a Midwesterner, you kind of fundamentally change their day. They're likely to question all of their life's choices, think of why they're such a drain on society, and drive right into a fucking lake. So a little bit different there. Speaking of driving, I actually learned how to merge in Boston. I was on this road called Storrow Drive. It was a nightmarish, hellacious, asshole road. And it was basically every road in Boston. Those of you that are in Chicago, it's basically an upper version of Lower Wacker, just all messed up. So I was driving my coworker home via Storrow Drive. And I was, of course, in the wrong damn lane. And it was rush hour. And I looked over at the other lane and it was there was no room. There was absolutely no room to merge. And I said, well, can't we just stay in the lane we're in now? And he was like, well, no, it's going to be like a 3-hour commute if you do. And he's like, you can merge over there. And I said, dude, I don't drive like you do. I'm Midwestern. And that didn't go over so well. And he was like, I think you can do it. I think you can merge. And then I'm like, oh man, I'm so sorry, but shit's going to get real here. I have a confession to make. I go a lot of places in Boston I don't want to go. Just to merge. So yeah, I got that courage and I merged that day and I drove all the way up to Melrose and dropped him off and I found the nearest body of water and drove right into it. So one of the things I've noticed is that there is a bit of a lingo difference between Chicago and Boston. Like here, I'm going to strap on my tennis shoes, drink my pop and just drive right on down the Dan Ryan. So I was talking to one of my coworkers in Boston and I said that I like the show Pawn Stars. I get a look and I didn't understand. I'm like, yeah, Pawn Stars. And I said, yeah, I actually watched an episode last night where there was this woman with a flute that had been passed down through her family. They all used the flute a lot. They loved it. And she was just in the store showing them her flute. And I got an even weirder look and I still didn't understand. And then so he just looked at me and he said, so what kind of pawn you like? Girl and girl pawn. Group pawn. Pinky pawn. I'm like, oh boy. All right, fine. I like all kinds of pawn. So yeah, I learned that there were other words in Boston I didn't know, like packy. I had spent 8 years not knowing what that word was because I was kind of freaked out and I thought it was something you'd see on Pawn Stars. So yeah, thank you very much. This is fun.
Woo! Thank you so much, Jen. The other thing that you know, the other thing that you can tell that you're not from Boston is because you say via.
Oh, they stay in Boston.
They're so.